there's a clinical issue in the management of diabetes that I'm worried about, and it's the state of pharmacologic ketosis using powerful drugs. I've heard this term used now in the endocrinology world, and there are these drugs called the SGLT2 inhibitors. Yes. And can you shed any light on the idea that you can have ketoacidosis with normal glycemia? And I've never seen ketoacidosis with nutritional ketosis in 10 years of clinical practice until one of my patients was on one of these SGLT2 inhibitors.
Really?
And I'm concerned that there's an underlying disaster waiting to happen, and we need to know why these drugs do what they do. And until we have more research, I advise people not to take those medications.
Yeah, that's really interesting to hear. You know, I don't, as of now, we don't do any research on that, so I'm usually hesitant to talk about things I don't directly study, but it does sound like it's just, so you saw ketoacidosis in a patient that normal glycemic, what was their insulin levels? That's an important question, because we, you know, insulin really parallels, insulin's low, ketogenesis goes up, and vice versa. Like you saw the study with fasting patients, when you inject someone who's fasting, no food coming in, their glucose goes down and their beta hydroxybutyrate goes down because you can have runaway ketogenesis if your insulin, like I have a student that's type 1 diabetic, and he follows, interestingly, a ketogenic diet, low-carb ketogenic diet, and he can cut his insulin by like 70-80%. He does much better. I feel much safer with him being on it. He has much less lows and much less, you know, highs. Right. And if we look at his Dexcom, instead of going like this, it's like this. You know, it's like really tight.